What's going on, guys? Jeff Weibel here. I have a treat for you guys today. I'm wearing my Spectre 007 t-shirt. I am hanging out with the Ian Fleming Foundation today. Ian Fleming was the author of the James Bond novels, and I'm at a top secret location where a lot of the vehicles from the movies were. I'm in the USA right now. Can't say where I am. Boom, there's a hint, there's a sky over here. But check this out, we're gonna go through this whole hangar. Millions of dollars worth of James Bond vehicles in here. Let's go check it out. Okay guys, this is the hangar. Here we go. All this is non-for-profit and all these vehicles were in the movies. For example, this is from License to Kill, 1989. And they were using this for fireman practice and burnt this vehicle. And this is the vehicle, the stunt where the vehicle goes up on two wheels. So you'll see here, a lot of these vehicles are actually like hollow a lot and, you know, have double wheels and all this kind of stuff. So just insane. The amount of history that's in this hangar and dollar value. So this is the helicopter from Russia with Love. You can see here, and they have this. So yeah, leave a comment below if you, what's your favorite Bond movie? It's just fascinating the amount of vehicles here. So we got the Parahawk here from The World Is Not Enough, two of them. And this is incredible. I was up in here earlier. This is the Digger from Skyfall. They got this. This is worth $600,000 and they just got it donated. And you'll see the bullet holes up here when Patrice was shooting at Daniel Craig's Bond, and obviously he goes up through the hatch. Right, Anders? What's going on? Okay, and so here is the Aston Martin from The Living Daylights. We've got the missiles, and this ski actually comes out, that they have a hydraulic, but you can see on the interior, it's totally empty. All right, keep going. They got a vehicle here from The World's Not Enough, that they got. A lot of the stuff gets donated to the Ian Fleming Foundation. Here's Bond's rental car in the Bahamas, the Mondeo, and Live and Let Die, 1973. Boat here. This is the plane from License to Kill. Now you can see here's the prop of the Vulcan from Thunderball. So basically, there's booze over here, cigars. We're working on the vehicles this weekend. The Ski-Doos from Die Another Day. I'm under the plane. Crazy the Jenga that happened here. We have the Digger over top of the plane. Yeah, nothing gets broken. If it does, we fix it. So this is quite the treat. We got the Q-boat here. I was up in the Neptune earlier. It's tight in there. The Neptune, they put it underwater, you'll see here, and they had the scuba divers in here. The interior was never used for shots. Here we have the Jaguar. Comes with a Gatling gun, of course. So I might be driving the Jag later. It's just incredible. This is just a fun weekend. A lot of these vehicles, they go to shows, and there's some manuals. Wow. Like I said, like manuals here, going over stunts from the movie. It's windy, it's an airport. So there you have it, exclusive access in here to check out all these. You know, let me know in the comments, what's your favorite Bond movie? And, you know, have you grown up on the Bond movies? Or do you don't want to see any more Bond movies, Jeff? Just kidding. Of course you love it, right? So